Welcome back, everybody. Welcome if you're new. Today we're in the 358 modified here at Charlotte. I fixed my dirt problem. The thing was the graphics, the render dynamic track data, that was for some reason unchecked. I guess that might have been because like the new dirt update or whatever. I don't know. Whatever message popped up when I got on the other day, that was probably why. And that's why I could not see where the lines were when I ran the 305s, which is unfortunate. But I know I could run a time in the twos. My time here was people coming out of pit road, and I had to run a higher lane in turn one. So hopefully we can get down to the low threes or even into the twos for qualifying. That would be nice, at least. We are car number two here, so at least we're not car number one. So hopefully we can have a pretty good qualifying time, start somewhat up front. Still trying to get better at these cars. Not great at them yet. Just trying to keep the car as straight as we can while staying low. It's easier to do around 3 and 4 to me. I don't know why. It just like has a easier turn radius than in 1 and 2. Low 3, I'll take it. That's what I was hoping for, at least getting to the lower 3s. Instead of like the mid fours like I was, because it's gonna be somewhat tough to pass. I feel like track's gonna wear out some, and you might have to find some grip later on in the race. 4:25 on the second lap. Damn, he ran the ones. That is flying. I know I've ran in the mid twos. I think I ran like a 2:54 or a 2:44 or something like that in the last practice, or not the last practice, one earlier. And it was a little bit worse track condition than this, but I was able to run the bottom and get that kind of time. So we're going to be starting fifth so far, so got a couple people left to qualify, so I'll pick it up when we're getting ready to go green. Alright, we fell back to sixth, starting right at mid-pack pretty much with 11 cars in this race. Hopefully we can gain a couple spots in the race, that'd be great. Starting on the outside is going to be a little tougher, just because the bottom's going to be faster to start off with for sure. If you guys enjoy this kind of racing, hit that like and subscribe button. Let me know. That lets me know that you guys enjoy watching this kind of racing as well, and it helps me out a lot. Somebody just left. Who was that? Was that the guy who qualified last? No, he qualified 9th, so I don't know why he left. He gone. We're waiting on a couple guys, I think, to get in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're waiting on 10 right now, because 9th place left. The 10th place joins. Race will start up, because 9th place already left. Nope, he's back. Okay, never mind. I don't know what happened to him. Maybe he was having like a glitch or something. Don't know what happened. That's a fast, like, getting back into the lobby, though. That's good for him, at least. Probably gonna be waiting here most of the time. But if you guys have raced this week, let me know how you guys have done in it so far. Because I don't know what to really expect out of it. I wish I could have known that my dirt problem thing, that rendered dynamic track thing, like was unchecked when I raced the sprint cars on Thursday. That would have probably helped out, because I had no clue where the slick was at all. Like, it was all just flat dirt, and you couldn't see where any of the grip was built up or where it was slick at all. It was so weird. But now that we got that fixed, that shouldn't be a problem anymore. I think we lost like 20 iRating in the 305s on Thursday. We'll see how we can do here. That's also because we got wrecked as well. But that's alright. He's got a Pillsbury Doughboy car. I love it. That looks so nice too. That's funny. That's funny as hell. Got a red, white, and blue Pillsbury Doughboy. Never seen that before in my life. But hopefully we can have a clean race here. It's no cautions anyways, 30 laps, but hopefully we could not get knocked around and try to finish pretty well. Try to gain a couple spots in the race if we can. See what we can do when the track starts to wear out some, because everybody's going to be running right along the bottom. That's going to get worn out quite quick. These things suck driving at a really slow pace like this. Like, if you see everybody pretty much going back and forth, except the top two guys. I don't know what the hell my spotter is doing. He must have dropped his radio in water or something. Alright. Watch the leader. He can go at any point. He'll probably go midway through the corner. As soon as you can get a straight line off of 4. I could not see him there. That was a bad start for me. So I've got 7th to my inside now. Hopefully I could hold him down enough and get a good enough run off of 2. Alright, yeah, that's what I was hoping for. Being on the outside, at least if somebody was on the inside, try to hold them, not hold them down, because I was just running midline, but they couldn't really come up off the corner. Ooh, three car got the tire a little bit. Definitely don't want to do that. He's lucky he didn't go for a spin. Well, we're lucky too, because we would have ran straight into him. See if we can hold this low line though. Because low line's fast, but you can't come up off the corner very high, and they were like too wide, and I was trying to get under them. They'll probably have someone on the outside? No? Okay, I don't know where the guy that was on the outside went. Maybe he hit the wall or something. Or blinked, I'm not sure, because I never even saw him go anywhere. The guy that started ninth is behind me, the one that left and came back. He's making his way up really quick. Ooh, three car hit the brakes really hard in that corner. Try not to hit that tire. Or the guy in front of him, probably. A little bit of both. I try to have a little bit of a higher entrance into the corner. Tries to give me a straight run off. That seems to work decent for me. But we're up to fifth. We have fourth and third right in front of us. That was a bad entrance, but I should have a decent exit if I can keep it straight. You can see the guys up there. First place is just running like a little higher than the very bottom. Second place is running higher than him, like above the slick. Probably just able to keep their car really straight doing that. A real low line in. Not able to keep up the speed. These cars don't have too much motor, so it makes sense trying to run a little bit higher lane. Do not get your back tires in the slick, because that got me super loose right there. Try to stay in the throttle mostly. I let off a little bit going in to try to keep the car settled and not going around on me. Try not to get the rear tires spinning too much in the slick when it's sliding in. Getting really slick going into three though, that's my problem. I'm not doing good in three and four for that reason. Oh, he's gonna hit that tire. Yep. Oh god, I saw that coming, but I could not move out of the way quick enough. Got a little bit of damage from it, which was unfortunate, but it was just on like the back right. I don't think we hit the front right tire, so we should be fine steering wise. He went in super low there. I saw he was gonna hit that tire. I was hoping he'd bounce up higher. And whoever was running on the outside behind us, it might have been the guy that started ninth. Yeah, he's in last now in pit road. He got screwed from it too, because he bounced up high enough to where that guy just ran straight into him. Trying to get this outside lane working. Keep the car straight pretty well. It doesn't get too sideways on you. Seems like if you can get on somebody's outside, you can get by them. Because passing on the inside is tough. That threw a wrench in the plan for the race. That brought the hornet's nest all the way back to us. About gotten to the back of the sixth. Thought I was going to hit him. That scared me. I'm like trying to go in just above the slick and then stay right in the grip as much as I can. Six car ran a little lower coming off and it worked pretty well for him. Because we're getting a good run in on the corner on him because he's letting off to get low. Then he's getting a good run off pretty much. Two sideways there coming off. That lost some momentum. Wall, yep, barely slapped it. It wasn't too bad, didn't really hurt the car at all. Six car is making that lower lane work. I think the guy behind me is running the lower lane as well. The thing is, you need to come all the way out to the wall to be really fast with it. Oh, actually no, the guy behind me is not running that anymore. I thought that the red car on the outside behind me was eighth place. 7 cars making a move on the 8. 8 cars starting to fall back now. Good racing though. The only thing was the 3 car hitting that tire really kind of screwed us up a little bit. But that got me to the outside, and I kind of realize now that the outside's pretty quick. So that's the only positive out of it, I'd say. Eight cars going back low on the seven. Seven's gonna probably clear him there. Seven car is pretty quick right now. He's keeping his car really straight, not getting too sideways at all. What is it? Five car behind me? Yeah. Thought it was a two at first, but it was inverted for the mirror. So it was a five. Oh wait, I'm the two car. I'm an idiot. Oh god, who's that? Who's that? Lap car wrecked up there. Thank God we have enough room to come down. Don't know if the five saw that or he was just running low enough to where we could come down to miss that. Real tight racing here. Eight car really pinching up on the eight coming off the corner. Not hitting each other though. Need to try to get around this eight car. We got the six car inside, can't really do anything about it. I feel a little bit quicker than the eight. Six car is pretty quick on the bottom, but we get so much momentum on the high side. Should be able to clear the six here in a corner or two. And we're going to have like five laps left. Five, six laps left. But we're back up to fifth, finally, after all that. Try not to run over the eight.
Outside.
Was gonna throw a slider and then I thought second on it.
Outside. Clear outside.
I'm gonna slide up here. Don't hit the wall. That was super slow off the corner though, which was bad. Six car, there's a car in here outside. Like we were literally door to door, like evened up going into that corner. Maybe he thought he was gonna clear me before the corner or slide up right on me. I don't know. I had a really bad slide through one and two when I tried to come up in front of the eight. I think I stayed in the gas a little bit too long was the problem. But I know I can get by the eight is the thing, so I need to try and do that on the last lap or so, because can't really hold that bottom for too long. But I need this six car not to be on my inside when I need to go inside. Had to get on the brakes a little bit there, not to run into the back of the eight. Very tight racing though, this is fun. I feel a lot more competitive in these cars than I did the past season. Come on, eight car, go somewhere. I'm gonna probably finish sixth. Oh god, we're hitting. Oh god, that guy sent it in, the five car. We are probably going to be three wide at the line. Six car lost a couple spots there. That's unfortunate. Five car really sent it in and got the stick. That was good by the five. I thought he was going to slide straight up into us. That was a really fun, tight race there at the end. That was crazy. That five car sent that bitch in on the last corner. He hit the six out of the way. That's why the six lost so much. But we were so tight coming off of there. I bumped both of them trying to get a run. I wanted to try to go three wide, but it got tightened up. Five car sent it in. He really didn't send it in too low either. He just sent it in, got into the front left of the six just barely, which was unfortunate for the six. It straightened him out and really screwed him for the rest of the corner. But the five, that's what made the five car stick so well. And then we barely beat the six to the line too, so that was a lot of fun. That was kind of crazy. Let's go back to what lap was that, probably this, where the three car hit the inside. Yeah, he went super low. I tried to get on the brakes and miss him. It hit our back right in the... Oh, the 7 car got by that clean. I thought the, what was it? Who was that? 11 car? What happened to you then? Oh, something happened to him before this. Because he was right behind me running the outside. I thought he ran into the 3. I didn't know anything happened to him. Oh, they had some netcode issues. Oh, and then he gets into the wall. That was weird. Like, they're both just going for the same spot off the corner. 11 was a little low for the line that he should have been probably, but the 7 car is coming up too, fighting for the same spot on the track. But then there's definitely some netcode there. Like, how bad was that? Actually, no, it wasn't that bad. They were a lot closer than it looked like. Barely the slightest bit touched, but sends the 11 up into the wall and gets your front right up there, and then he spins around. Then he gets hit again, spun around into the wall. Damn, that's unfortunate. That's super unfortunate. And he got flipped upside down. Oh my. That's just terrible. He was doing pretty well too. Let's go back to the beginning of the race. See any incidents that happened. That was the first incident of the race, actually. The 11 car with the 7. That's just super unfortunate. He gets hit, and then he just goes and slowly flips over. That's just the worst. Next one was the 3 car. The next lap, hitting the inside tire. Flipped around. I barely clipped him. I'm so mad I clipped him. Man, that lost so much momentum for us. 9 car just goes in for a slide. Couldn't control it. Ooh, 10 car, nowhere to go. That's unfortunate. Like, he came all the way down the track. That's just really bad. Wrong place, wrong time for the 10. And his car is probably not driving well. And he's flipped upside down now. Did he land it? Oh, yeah, he does. And here come the leaders. Oh, wait, no, that was the 3 car. I thought the leaders were coming. Second place. Probably going to slap the wall, barely. And going into 3. Like, net code slap, it looked like. That was all. What happened? Oh, and that was that lap 26. Oh, my. Okay, why did you stop? Was he, like, that far down? Oh, yeah, he was 5 laps down. So that was the end of the race. But for some reason, he just decides to nail the brakes directly after the start-finish line. While the 10 car is still coming. Like, I don't know what your plan was there, 9. Like, because this guy is just trying to finish out the lap. And he might have actually aimed for him. It looks like he aimed for him. So that makes more sense. But, yeah, that was all the incidents for the race, but dang, we had a tight race there. The last, like, I don't know. Let's go back and see how long we were right here for. Because the 7 car got by the 8. I got stuck behind the 8 for too long. I wish I would have not slid up as much as I did. Because what lap is this? I think that we get by the 6. That was where the lap car was wrecked up top, and the 5 car was really low. I could not tell how low he was. But luckily, he was super low, and we were able to come down some. But we get by the 6, because I thought the 6 was going to pull up at some point, but I really closed the gap up to the 8 before he could do that. But these last 10 laps were just really tight racing. A lot of fun. A lot of fun. I do feel a little bit more competitive in these cars than I did last season. It feels like I'm able to control it a little bit better. I did get sideways a few times too much earlier on in the race when I was trying to run the low side, but once I started running the high side, it was pretty good for me. The only thing was, when I went to go throw the slider, I really messed that up. I need to work on that, because I don't throw those often, and I don't practice those at all. So, it made so much sense why, when I threw it in the one, that it was just really awful. I think right here I had a decent run. No, this is not where I went low. It might have been the next lap, because we got singled out here. And I think I go low here, because the 8 kind of slid too far up, and I had a good run. I should have probably thrown it here, going in between the 7 and the 8, but the 8 actually had a pretty good run there, so that might not have worked out. I thought I was going to have enough room here, which I did. I definitely did, but I just went too straight. That was my problem. I got way too straight going in. When I went to go throw it, I should have went lower and slid up slower. Instead, I went in like middle, and it just slid me straight up, and I did not do it well enough. I think I stayed on the gas like pretty much the whole time. I let off a little bit, but I was just sliding too much at that point. So that was just bad. That was bad on my part. Because I definitely, yeah, and I think the 6's car just didn't turn at that point. Because either that or he was trying, yeah, he was turning in early. His back end hit the side of me, and that's what kept him up there and together. So that was unfortunate for him. Because I was wondering what happened there, because we were straight side by side, but he wasn't trying to run the outside, it looks like. His back end just barely clipped me and brought him back up to me. And then we just had a really tight race there to the end. Like, the last few laps, the 6 car started running that bottom really well. Like, right here, he had a really good 1 and 2. He ran super low. It would actually keep up a decent amount of momentum. Still cleared him there. But I was really trying to set up the 8 car for, like, a last lap thing. He had a really good 3 and 4. That's what kept him there. 3 and 4, it seems like you can actually hook that bottom and keep up a good amount of speed. 1 and 2, you lose a lot off of 2. It seems like you lose more off of 2 than you do 4. But he had a really good 1 and 2 there, too. And then at that point, I was just kind of stuck here. I couldn't go 3 wide, because the way that he was sliding up off of the corners, I didn't want to wreck all of us. But hell, that was a tight race. I like having a fun, close race like this. That was a lot of fun. right here, this is the last lap, isn't it? Yeah, that slowed them. That slowed me and the six down enough for the five to throw that. If I wouldn't have done that, I don't think the five could have gotten all the way to the side of us. Because you see how far out the eight got down the backstretch? Because we were like right bumper on him. Like just on his bumper. And this slowed us down in time. Well, I let off because I didn't want to wreck us either. But it just slowed us down so much compared to where the eight was. We should have been up here. And then that probably wouldn't have happened with the five. And so I would have been right with the eight still. And probably would have finished in fifth, which is unfortunate. But hey, tight racing, that happens sometimes. I need to work on my sliders a little bit because I think I could have finished in fourth. Because I think I could have beaten the eight out. I felt a little quicker than him, but I messed up the slider too bad. That wasn't going to happen. Seven cars fast coming up through the field and had a good tight race. That was a lot of fun, so can't complain about that. I just wish the three wouldn't have hit that tire because that really screwed up a little bit of our race. But good win by the one. Him and the four were checked out from the beginning. They were super fast, so... Finishing 6th, car number 2, definitely going to lose a little bit of iRating, but that's alright. I like having a fun race like this anyways, so let's go see what we end up getting. Alright, results in. Strength of field just over 2,400. I think there was 2 splits. Yeah, there was about 20-something that registered for it, so that makes sense. The 1 car was fastest by far. 4 car kept up with them for the most part, but they never really had a battle at all. The 1 car was just too fast, starting on pole, and had a really good start. I didn't have a very good start either, though, because I didn't have a good start because I didn't see the leader when he actually started going. Everybody else started moving, that's when I started going. But I had a really tight race between, like, the mid of us, like, 4 of us, 5 of us in the mid-pack. 7 car got by us and then took off, and then there was no catching him. And the 8 car, I feel like, kind of held us up, but not, like, on purpose. Like, I feel like I was a little faster, I just couldn't get by him. And I just messed up the slider too much. That was my bad. Lose 41 iRating, not the worst thing in the world. Had a fun race, though. That's all I could really ask for. I'd like having a tight race like this. Even if we lose some iRating, I'd rather have a good, fun, tight race like this than just, like, winning by, like, 10 seconds. It's more fun having a close race like this. And it also makes me better because there is a lot of fast guys here. Number 1 car had, like, just under 4,350, it seems like. So I'm not that far away from him in iRating. I lost a lot in the last 2 races. 61, I think, in the last 2 races. So that's unfortunate. So going to try to slowly work our way back up. I think the next race I'm going to do is the super late models because I think they're at... Shit, where were they? I forgot. I completely forgot where they were at. I want to say... Man, I don't even remember where they're at. The super late models, I liked where they were at, and I'm going to run that. Didn't really like a lot of what was on the oval side this week. I thought that Talladega was this week, but that's next week. I had the weeks mixed up, so that's my bad for saying that earlier in the week. I said I was going to run like the trucks or Xfinity at Talladega, but they're not there. So I will run that next week for sure, and going to move on, try to get some iRating back in the super late model race. Hopefully we can have a fun race there. I haven't ran those in quite some time, but... Also, first time this season with them. And I actually ended up with 4X. When did I end up with 4X? I know I got a 2X from the 3 car. Who else did I get a 2X from? I honestly don't even know. I have no clue where else I got a 2X from, unless it was like tapping the wall. But I don't think I hit the wall hard enough to get a 2X. I don't know what the hell happened, so... It is what it is. I'm fine with the incident points. We only lost 0.09. I have a ton of safety ratings, so I'm not worried about that. That'll come back real quick, because I don't get into things often. But that was a fun race. I wish we could have gotten around the 8. Could have probably finished 4th and maybe not lost as much iRating, but maybe still would have lost a little bit being car number 2. But that was a fun race. Appreciate you guys for watching as always. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the race nonetheless. It was a very tight, close, like packed race. You could see the, what was the finishing times? 5:36, 6:36. So I was literally 1/10 behind him, and he was 6:72 because he was like right on my side. So that was super close, but right there at the end, 5 car really got 2 spots there right in the last corner. So that was a good job by him. He gained 10 iRating for it because of that. He would have probably lost a little bit finishing 7th or 6th, maybe too. He might have just gotten like 2 finishing 6th. So that was a fun race. Appreciate you guys for watching as always. I already said that, and I'll catch you guys in the next race.